Hello and welcome back to my channel. It's me, Paper Izzy. Today I'm gonna do something a little different. I bought a discount thing of slime and I'm gonna turn it into an original character after I play with it. Today is also the first video I'm ever doing with a voiceover, so we'll see how that goes. I have no idea, I've never done it before, but look at me being a YouTuber for once in my 10 years on YouTube. So let's get right into it. It is a crazy art slime, which that should have been my first red flag, called Purple Smoothie. It says it has a sweet scent. I could not smell any sweet scent if there was one. I do apologize. I got it from Hobby Lobby. I know Hobby Lobby is a terrible place. I'm so sorry that I went there, but it was discounted, so $1.99 from Hop on a Knob Lobby. Again, that should have been a red flag. So, first off, it was really hard to open. You can see me struggle with it for a little bit. And I eventually just go ahead and grab an ink pen that looks like a cactus to open it, which also might have not been a good idea because I could not get the slime out. It was just too much. So as I'm opening the slime, or trying to, it's so sticky. Like I said, it was, I think, completely deactivated. Oh no. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh god. No. Okay, I can't do anything with this. I had to get my husband to get me a paper towel just to get some of it off my fingers so I could try to open it more. And it just kept falling over, and it was just, for a second, it seemed like absolute disaster.
Please don't let that happen. Don't let that happen. I didn't know what to say.
Absolute disaster. Also, I was kind of upset because there was a thing in the bottom, like they do with food sometimes now, where it looks like the jar is going to be full, but it's not full because they're trying to rip you off, and Crazy Art definitely tried to rip me off, so I was kind of upset about that, but the slime was trash anyway, so I guess that's that. There's no, good ASMR of it because it just didn't make any noise. It was just, a liquid. It was awful. I'm so sorry. I was trying to play with it some to mix it together, hoping because there's supposed to be a white swirl or whatever, so I was hoping when I got to that maybe that would help me mix it together, but unfortunately it did no such thing. It was just awful. It's giving a very strong Ivan Ooze vibes, though. I will give it that. That's probably what drew it. Ugh. That's probably what, oh my god, I forgot how to speak English. That's probably what drew me to it in the first place. That doesn't sound right. I was drawn to it because it looked like something Ivan Ooze adjacent. I'm so sorry, I don't know how to speak English. I'm so sorry. But yeah, it's a pretty final color. I like the sort of light purple. But yeah, the slime was just garbage. I just threw it away because I don't have any activator or anything. Like I said, I'm pretty sure it was completely deactivated. It was just so sticky. It was going everywhere. You can see it was a disaster. Alright, so now we're going to the drawing portion of the video. I had a few ideas in mind already, so I just started going. First off, she's gonna be a cute girl because I always draw cute girls. That's just I don't know. Sailor Moon, I guess, can be to blame for that. But the head shape, I kind of want it to be a little square-ish to kind of resemble, how a jar would look straight on. So, I don't know. It's an interesting head shape, so I think it fits with the character design. After that, I wanted to give her, droopy eyes, kind of. I don't know how else to say it. They're not really droopy. Like, I mean, it literally looks like they're, like, wavy. And I also wanted to do that to the hair, kind of to resemble just how gooey and messy the slime was. I thought that was, like, a cute look. So I did that. Afterwards, I kind of put streaks in the hair to represent how the slime was supposed to have, like, the purple and white stripes to it. The purple and white stripes. Which, of course, did not really come out in the final slime at all. On the picture on the front, it looked like, oh, it's all swirled together. But no, it was not like that. But I at least wanted to incorporate that into the design some. I also really like, I added a hair bow to her to sort of represent the clearance tag that was on the top. And I really like that little pop of orange. So you'll see that later, like when I color it. But I also tried to make her body vaguely like jar shaped. And I added more stripes because I think the stripe motif is pretty neat. The skirt has like the diagonal stripes that's sort of to imply like the reflection on like a clear bottle. The boots and the gloves, I wanted them to look kind of gooey, duh, because, you know, gooey, slimy, gunk. Ugh, God, I'm not selling it, but I think it was neat. When I started coloring, I wanted to do the skin color kind of to match the final slime color, which was a really pretty purple. So I tried to do like the lightest purple I have. It was more or less successful. I would have preferred a lighter purple, but I'm using an assortment of markers because my New Year's resolution this year is actually not to buy any new markers the whole year because I have so many markers at the house. Like, one day I will give you a full marker tour. It's a problem. I have a serious problem with buying art supplies. So I'm going to try not to buy any new markers this entire year, so we'll see how it goes. I also wanted to do some of the darker purples for the accents. The skirt is blue and white, like I said, just to kind of reminisce, like, sort of, like, a reflection on, like, a bottle or a jar or something. And back to the orange. We have some orange accents. Her blush is orange. I don't know how that would work in real life, but the drawing, it looks cute. Her hair bow is orange. I like that little pop of color. It gives you a little something different to work with. Yeah, and then I start shading because that's a thing people do. People shade. It's so funny because sometimes I look at my older art and some of it is just like not shaded, and I'm like, just a little bit of shading probably would have made a huge difference. So don't skip shading, kids. Also, while I'm drawing, my dog decides to jump up and he's barking throughout, and it's just really annoying, and the camera's moving and shaking, and it's really funny because me and my husband are both like, okay, son, you can calm down. But, you know, he's a dog. He's going to do what he wants to do. So, I get it. Chester. I love you, but you gotta sit still, please. So then I decided to use the lid as like a circle to like trace for the background. I don't know if you could hear that, but my dog just sighed and it was so funny. Just like he has big problems. That is too funny. But yeah, so I used the lid to trace a circle. It was a little difficult, but I got it. It's a little rough, but that's okay. You know, it's hand-drawn art. It's gonna happen. I wanted to do the background to be like a teal, sort of to coordinate with like the light purple, light blue. I felt teal really fit in there. I don't know, maybe there's some color theory with it, but I don't know. Like I said, it's a little rough, but it's alright. Thank you. a little bit through coloring the background, my marker decides that it's going to start dying. Like I said, I'm trying to use up my marker, so some of them have less juice in it than others. That one just has less juice. So I had to switch to a different marker, but I kind of like how it gives it like a little bit of dimension, a little bit of, you know, it's not just one flat color, it gives it like a gradient almost. So I like that. And at the end, I just sort of start re-outlining her just to give her a darker outline. And then I came up with her name. I was thinking like what it could be, and I decided on ZZ. I just think that's a cute little, I think it's a cutesy little name, and it kind of alludes to crazy art. And I just really like the name, and I really think the character turned out pretty cute. I love how purple she is. I can't wait to draw her again. And yeah, tell me what you think of this video, if you liked it or not. It is a little different. Like I said, doing a voiceover for the first time, some character design. And just tell me what you think. Make sure to comment below. Tell me what you think about the character, what you think about the slime, if you want to see more like this. And make sure to like and subscribe. Press the button, press the bell, do the things. And make sure you, like I said, like and subscribe. That's about it, and I hope to see y'all again soon. Thank you for all the new subscribers, and I love you guys, and I'll see y'all later. Adios, amigos. Goodbye.